In this video, we'll show you how to make an electronic check payment in Webfile. If you don't have a Webfile account, view our How to Create a Webfile Profile video. Payment by electronic check requires you to enter your banking information. With this option, you can file early and postpone payment up until the due date. Please remember, you can pause this video at any time. Once you have input your report data, you will be taken to the payments portal where you can choose your payment type. Options include credit card, electronic check, or make a filing without a payment. In this example, we'll be selecting the electronic check option. The payment portal page may reflect total tax due, balance due, and pending payments. Returns and payments that have not been completely processed will not be reflected. Please note that franchise tax account balances are not reflected in Webfile. A payment is not submitted at this point. You will be prompted for your financial information, and you have the option to modify the payment amount after selecting the payment type. Select the payment type electronic check. If the return has been filed, the amount due will populate in the amount to pay box. Please verify the payment amount is correct. If you need to make changes, you can adjust the amount of the payment in the amount to pay box. If the return has not been filed, you must enter the amount to pay. If you make payments only for sales tax or direct pay and the return has not been filed, you must enter the state and local amounts due. Select the advanced edit to enter the state and local amounts. The amounts you enter will be combined with the total amount on the summary page. Select either checking or savings for the type of bank account you would like to use. Now enter the 9-digit routing number and the account number for the account that will be debited. You'll need to re-enter the bank account information for verification. Your bank routing number and bank account number are located on the bottom of the checks issued by your financial institution. Look in the lower left-hand corner of the check. This is the standard location of all the routing numbers. Bank account numbers are typically located just to the right of your bank account routing number. Please note that the numbers listed on your deposit slip may differ from the numbers listed on the check and should not be used. Select the payment effective date. You can choose the payment effective date up to 30 days in advance. Just make sure it's before the tax due date. Select agree and continue. You may return to the payment option screen at any time by selecting the back arrow. The payment portal summary screen provides the ability to confirm that the payment information is correct. Once the payment has been submitted, it cannot be amended or canceled. If you need to amend or cancel a submitted payment, you must contact your financial institution to initiate a stop payment. Select Submit Payment to initiate your payment or to submit a return with a payment. You will receive a confirmation page when you have successfully submitted your payment. It's very important to print or save this page for your records. If you're submitting a return with your payment, this will be reflected on the confirmation page. Once you've completed printing the confirmation page, select Continue. You will be returned to the Sales Tax menu, where you may review the payment and return history. The View Return Summary option allows you to view your electronic submission history. Select the button next to the View Transaction History and select Continue. The View Transaction History screen lists all the returns and payments you've submitted in your Webfile account. Payment processing times may vary. The typical processing time is 3 to 5 business days. Payments reflect the submission date and the payment effective date. This concludes how to make an electronic check payment using our Webfile system. If you need further assistance, please email us at webfile.help@cpa.texas.gov or call 1-800-442-3453.